Someone remember me talking, someone remember talking me last year about this topic for 5 minutes? Where I said, oh, well, it could, would be nice to...
Microphone.
All right.
Hello?
Yes.
Last year I talked about this pun topic of chromatic, and things getting serious because I'm about or beginning to write my own book in that series, because the series of articles is now finishing and it will become a book. And during this effort, also some libs and some tools will be created. Some already arrive with which are quite useful, but I want especially talk about this one because it has to do with the topic I spoken last year about. Because last year I just said, oh, it would be nice, because 2 years ago I spoke about Rebo and how they do insane, with insane few syntax, very much GUI. It's about GUI programming. And I think it's something very much of you are not so quite fond of doing design. You are fond of doing open your editor, typing your content into it, and the rest should do a good module who makes out the design or the GUI. And that is where I'm heading. And what we have now are some basic classes who are scramble some parameter and resemble some GUI, because it's, if you have native Perl data structure, it's much nicer if we have some ugly XML. You know, lots of brackets and this and that. Why? No, and open brackets, size of that. If you have such a simple array of items, you know, we want to join them with the sizer. If an array inside, it has to be also a sizer in the other direction. So this way we can make a simple grid. We have a number that's a space. If there's some text in our YAML or JSON structure, that should supposed to be a label. I think you get the idea. Just very few syntax. For instance, how modern wiki markups, it's the same principle, and produce a lot of GUI. Yeah, if you went very far, it can be even becoming cross-platform, so the same data structure can be built up in TK or whatever. Yeah, I think that would be a really nice thing that I'm heading. If you want to join me, I'm Lichtkind on CPAN, and that's about it. Yeah.